What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to connect to your Minecraft server through an FTP. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. There are a few different ways to access the files on your server, which can be through our panel or by using a third-party site like CyberDuck or FileZilla. These options are going to bring you to your FTP or file transfer protocol, which is how you're going to do things like add mods, backup your world, and a lot more. Both of these options have their pros and cons, but any server owner should definitely take the time to learn both of them. Let's jump into how to use and work through your FTP. An FTP service is designed for transferring files over the internet from one system to another, which is most often between a user and a server. This allows users to download, upload, move, and rename files and folders, usually through a third-party application. But when you're hosting with Apex, our panel includes a built-in FTP, which can be used to quickly adjust your data and even zip and unzip files online. This is the first and most popular method for our users, since it's a lot easier to navigate and understand. While this makes it perfect for first-time server owners, there is a limit to the sizes of files that will work, which is where an external site would come in. To get to your panel FTP, first head to your Apex server panel, and we always recommend stopping the server before making any changes to any of the files. Afterwards, enter the FTP file access section on the left-hand side, and then enter your panel login password and press login. Now that you're in the FTP file access, you can start looking through the folders and the files. Clicking a folder name is going to allow you to enter that directory and view any of the folders or files inside. Clicking a file's name or the download button will download it to your computer. Included in this panel FTP is also a variety of file management tools to adjust your files and folders. New folder, which creates a new folder in the current directory. New file, which creates a new file in the current directory. Upload, which allows you to upload a file into the current directory. Select all, which selects all of the files on the current page. Move, which moves any selected items to a desired area. Delete, which deletes any of the selected items from your server. Copy, which copies the select items to a desired directory. Rename, which changes the names of any of your selected items. Wget, which allows you to download a file to your server through a URL or FTP. And then zip, which compresses selected items into a zip file. And then unzip, which unzips those zip files into a desired directory. In addition to all of these tools, you can also press edit to the far right of a compatible file to edit the contents directly. This is used when editing configuration files for plugins, mods, or any other text-based file. After you make any of those changes, always make sure to press save to make sure the changes take effect. As this error states, if you try to log in and it's saying you have the wrong password, first, make sure that the password you're using is your panel password and not your billing account password. Of course, also make sure you're typing the password correctly and that the caps lock is not accidentally enabled. If you're trying to upload a file and it's freezing up on the panel, then the file might just be too big for the panel to run. So you'll need to use an external FTP, which lucky for you, we are going to go over right now. The second method of managing your server files is through an external FTP application. While some can find it a bit harder to manage, here you're able to upload and download much larger files, and the click and drag function makes it much easier to relocate entire files. To connect, you're going to head to the Apex panel and enter into the FTP file access and stay on that login page. Next, you're going to download and launch your desired external FTP client. There are a few different options, but today we're going to be focusing on FileZilla. In the new program, enter your connection details from the login page, including the address host, the port, the username, and the password. If a message prompt appears, press OK or accept, and then you should now have access to all of your server files. If you have different server profiles on your panel, then you might have a few different folders when you connect. Since usually every profile is running a different game, make sure you're choosing the right profile before you make any changes to the files inside. Unlike the panel FTP, an FTP client is usually much more straightforward for uploading and downloading files, and its limitations are a lot smaller. While each program might not look the exact same, most will have the same abilities, like uploading large files directly to the server, downloading large files or folders to your computer, clicking and dragging items to upload, download, and move locations, and renaming or deleting server files and folders. If you get an authentication failed error when you're trying to connect, it might mean that either your username or password has been entered incorrectly. Make sure you're using the info on the FTP page in the panel. While your password is the same as your panel login, your FTP username is not the same. The password is also case sensitive, so make sure to manually type it in and that caps lock is not on accidentally. If a critical error appears instead of the authentication error, this means the information entered in either the host or the port is wrong. Like before, make sure you're using the host from the login page as well as the FTP port, which is not the same as your server port. If even your external FTP is having trouble uploading a large folder, then we recommend zipping that file and trying again. This should improve both speed and stability since the server is uploading one large file instead of a ton of smaller ones. Once a zip is uploaded, you can unzip it again using the panel FTP. If you have a server, it's inevitable that one day you're going to have to enter the FTP, so why not be prepared? It looks daunting at first, but it's actually super easy to understand if you have the right tools to do it. As for what you can do in these files, we have tons of videos on how to upload different mods, plugins, and more using this feature, so you'll be a pro in no time. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.